thank you for joining me on Garage Gym Guru. I appreciate you coming back to the channel and joining me, where I'm going to go over the urethane plate six shooters by Rogue, why I got them, and as you can see behind me, my gym looks a little different with my monster rack. All the calibrated plates are gone. I've actually have sold them. I got a pretty good deal with them. That's the kind of one of the important things in taking care of your equipment in your own garage gym, besides the fact of looking at it every day. But the fact that you ever decide to get something different and you want to sell them, I would suggest keep your stuff in good shape. They sell way better. Besides the fact Rogue always sells, it keeps its price. And if you keep them in great shape, people want them. So they're going to a good home. So the reason why I did this was I wanted something different, like I've told you guys before. I wanted to go ahead and get plates that I could hold on to, had a grip on them. I felt like even though the calibrated plates were beautiful with the colors, I loved them. I loved the way they looked in my rack. And my rack looks a little plain, but that's going to change up a little bit. I wanted something that was a little better for what I do without working out. I don't need the calibrated plates for powerlifting. I wanted something more for weightlifting. So I've got two of them in here. I've got the 10s and the 45s, which I'm going to show you, explain to you. And you're going to see some pictures, obviously, if you haven't seen them already. We'll see which way they're going to go in. But I'm still waiting for Rogue to have the 25s and 35s come in stock. Now, what I did was I got two sets of 10s, and I've got three sets of the 45s. I need one set of 25s, one set of 35s. Yes, because 35s are important, in my opinion. And I need to get one set of 5s. Now, I'm going to be using these on my bars, and I'm also going to be using them on my new lat pull-down low row machine that I'm going to get from, I'm waiting for from Texas Strength Systems, which I'll do a review on once it comes in. Everything's on back order because of the virus. So anyway, let's get into these plates. So this is a 10 pound, all right? These are excellent, okay? I'm going to tell you the good and the bad, and I'm still waiting for a response from Rogue because, look, I'm pretty particular. If I'm going to spend money on things, I want them to come in right. And if there's any issues whatsoever, I'm going to make sure they know about it. So this is a 10 pound, typical 10 pound plate. But what I like is I don't have to be so careful with it, for one. And I know a lot of you guys don't care about that, and some of you guys do. But this has got that urethane on it, which is fantastic, okay? The lettering plate comes in nice with white and everything. The plate's a little slippery. It did come with some discoloring on it, but it's nothing horrible. But this is a 10 pound plate. What I like is that it's got the metal ring in the middle, so it's not going to transfer any paint onto the bars. It also slides on nice and easy. It just feels differently than the plates I've had before. It kind of feels, reminds me a little bit of when I had bumper plates and they had the steel in the middle also, whereas I have these calibrated plates here. It just, everything kind of felt a little different. So these are the 10 pounds. They're really good. There are no holes, obviously. They are a little slippery, like I said, so when you carry them, you're gonna have to just be careful. All right, so on to the next, the 45 pound plate. And I'm gonna do also some talking too and show you guys a little bit of video a little closer, because I know a little bit of a distance here. Same thing. This isn't as slippery though. A little discoloring on here, which is what I told Rogue about. I sent them in an email. I felt like it looked like there was water damage. I don't think it's water damage, but who knows, but that's what it looks like. So I did send them an email letting them know that I had about two plates that had some discoloring around here, which you're gonna see on the pictures. And then one of my plates actually looked like the lettering, just on one, was bubbling up a little bit. Didn't look like it was gonna peel so much, but it's possible that it might. And if I'm gonna pay the money I did for these, because as you guys know, if you ever looked them up, they are more expensive than most of the plates because of the urethane. Six shooter, because they have six holes. What I like is, and I just used them this morning, I did some exercises with just the plate. I did some skull crushers, and it was nice to have something to really hold on to. It's also nice to be able to take these off the rack, which they will not be staying on the rack, but then put them on the bar. My plan, as you guys can see, is now that there is no plates on my rack except for these, is I'm not going to have plates on my rack anymore. I know I said in my rack video that I kind of like doing everything on the outside, but what I decided was is I took all the plates off the rack and I'm leaving it open so I can do shoulder presses and I can do rows inside, back rows inside of the rack. And then on the outside of the rack is going to be for all bench press, incline, decline, stuff like that. So what I actually ordered from Rogue was also one of their plate trees. I'll do a quick review on that. There are a few reviews, these will all go on that net, where they're in a central location for the lat pull-down machine and also for my rack, my barbells. So back to these. What else can I really say? all in black. You can feel that they're solid. There is no true issues with these that I feel like they're going to break or the coating's gonna come off. I haven't had them very long. I do like I said, the piece of metal that's on the inside. It's nice when you put them on and off the bar. It just feels different than the other plates. I like the grip on it. I like that it has the holes and it's easier to get on and off of, well, now the rack, but will be the plate tree because you can do it with one hand. The calibrated plates, although they are awesome, holding them with one hand is almost impossible unless you just have a fantastic grip. You could do it with the 25s and 35s. When you get down to the 45s and 55s, it's a little harder. Like I said, I am waiting to order 5s, 35s, and 25s for these as well, one set of each. Let's see what else I can go into with these. You can see on the edges here, and I'm going to show some more video. Actually, let's do that. We're going to go ahead and we're going to start another part of this. I'm going to show you a little more in depth of what it looks like and closer up. But as far as review goes, these plates are really good. I really enjoy them.
Nice view from the bottom to the top, because I'm sure if you're thinking about these plates, you want to know exactly how they look like in person, in real life. I don't think there's many reviews. I haven't seen any on these plates. The black urethane plates by Rogue, six shooter, awesome. So, like I said, there were a couple things. You can see some miscoloring on this thing. This one, I have other ones that discoloring is worse on the other one. And on the one of the plates, whereas you can see this plastic Rogue logo actually is indented, if that's the right way to say it, is actually in the plate. It doesn't stick out, which is nice. But on the one plate, it's kind of bubbling out a little bit, which is odd. So waiting for a response from Rogue, we'll see what happens with that. So looking at the holes in the center here, as you can see, they're nicely done. There's nothing sticking out on any of these things as far as where it seals up. On the outside, the same thing, no issues. They're nice and smooth. I mean, they're as good as they can be. But remember, these plates are, when they use urethane plates, these are supposed to last. I know commercial gyms use these, big box gyms use urethane plates because they're supposed to be taking a beating. Now, you're not supposed to drop these like bumper plates. They are not bumper plates, and you will be able to tell because when you put bumper plates together, there's rubber hitting rubber. When you put these plates together, they sound like steel plates hitting each other, right? Now, having them on the rack, you don't hear them clank together like regular steel plates, but when you put them together, they do sound that way because underneath here is that material. It's just the outer coating, which is great. They're nice because if you're in a garage like I am, you should not have any problem with them rusting or anything like that. They should last for a while, which is why they're more expensive. And I'm really excited about these plates. And I'll be honest, the biggest thing I'm excited for is the fact that they have the holes and they're going to be easier for me to grip and get on and off the bars. Okay. As you can see, my rack here, like I told you guys, I'd show you, is bare. Let's see if I can get a better view. Nope, that's the wrong one. Right, so now it looks a little different. So what I'm doing with this, since we're talking about these plates and I've shown you guys my rack already, my gym is changing a lot and I'm keeping my bench here with this rack here because I am actually selling that fat pad bench right there. I do not need it any longer. But no longer do I have the calibrated plates here. And as you can see, I have J cups on the bottom and the top. And those are just going to be for certain exercises to do inside the rack. I will be doing a review soon. Actually, I saw a review from Kurt Locker on YouTube. And he actually showed these things that go on to your J cups and actually go on to the spotter arms on the outside to protect them. And they come in different colors. So I'm waiting for those to come in and I'll do a review on them. But back to the plates here. No issues with these guys. True issues. The discoloring is a little bothersome. The lettering is a little bothersome, but as far as being good plates, they're fantastic. Let me know if I missed anything and if you have any questions, and I'll talk to you guys next time. Thanks.